All right, take a look at this. This is the GF8200-A-E, and this is a sweet little board for you AM2 fans. Hyper Transport 3.0, AM2 Plus, Semprons, Athlons, Phenoms are all going to work on here. It's a micro ATX board. It's quite small. It's got four DIMMs, so it's not kind of the low end of the Zotac line. It's actually right in the middle for their micro ATX boards. And let's take a look at it because it's got a lot of great features. We'll start by talking right here, right about the socket. It is AM2 Plus. It will do Hyper Transport 3.0, 5200 megatransfers per second, which is about 2600 megahertz. Another cool thing about this board is that it has onboard graphics. So down here somewhere inside underneath this heatsink, you do have a GeForce 8200 chipset. Now you do have PCI Express 2.0 right up here. So if you want to do hybrid SLI, you can. Hybrid Power or GeForce Boost will both work. You got to use an 8 series card that supports it, which is just going to be another 8200. But if you do want to do that, that gives you the benefits of efficiency and then having two cards when you need a little bit more horsepower. You do have four DIMM slots over here. These are going to get you up to 8 gigabytes of DDR2, and it will support 1066 megahertz natively, or you can overclock a little higher, but a lot of those DDR2s are not going to go very high anyway. That's about as high as you want to go. Some of them will go to 1200, but you're going to pay way too much money, and for that, you might as well upgrade to something a little bit bigger and better. You have six SATA headers if you look over here. That is pretty impressive for a micro ATX board of this size, and the RAID options are even better. You have all of them. 0, 0+1, 1, and 5 are all available. So those are the most popular ones that you're most likely going to be using, and that's going to give you enough to do just about anything, whether it be a home theater PC, maybe a small gaming build, and if you're confused, this could definitely be a gaming build board. You know, not super high end, but absolutely, you can put a Phenom 2 on here. You can throw a nice graphics card because you do have that PCI Express slot, and you can even use the onboard graphics when you're not using the big video card. Now let's talk about this PCI Express X16 2.0. Besides that, right below it, you got a PCI Express X1, and you have two standard PCIs, so TV tuners or peripherals, whatever you want, fiber cards, they're all going to fit on there. If you look over here, you got quite a few USB headers around, so that's going to be an additional four USB 2.0s that you're going to be able to add to your case or to a back panel connector if you have one of those. If you look at the actual back panel on this board, you have quite a bit of connectivity. Starting from the far end over here, you got two PS2s, you have your coaxial SPDIF, you got your DVI and your VGA D-sub. You have four USB 2.0 ports right here underneath this 10100 1000 Ethernet, and then you have 5.1 channel HD audio that's going to come out right through there. So very, very nice little micro ATX board. It's the Zotac GF8200-AE. It's not too small, it's not too big, but it's got all the stuff. You got a big big CPU you can put in there, you got a big video card you can put in there, small board, big CPU, big video card, still means big performance. It doesn't really matter how big the board is. Really good stuff from Zotac. If you have any questions on it, email me, and I'll see you guys next time. For more information on the Zotac GF8200-AE Micro ATX motherboard, type in Z700-2010 into the search engine of any of these major retailers. For Computer TV, I'm Albert.